Sony is a leader in home theater audio and video products. Our next guest happens to be the senior manager for the home audio and video technology department for Europe. And that's Eric Kingdon from Sony. Hello, Eric. Welcome into Tomorrow. How are you?
I'm fine, Dave. Thanks very much for having me along here, giving me a chance to talk to you.
It's a pleasure to have you. You guys, of course, have, I think, the single biggest stand, if you will. They call them stand here, but exhibits in all of IFA. You're showing so many cool things. I don't know where to start.
Yeah, I mean, we don't have enough time to go into everything.
There's
so much stuff. I mean, everything from super fast display systems using 200 hertz display technology. So when you see fast moving objects, they look really so clear. We've got new Blu-ray players for the best in high definition home entertainment experience. Products that can connect to the internet so you can interact with other watchers and users online, stuff you can download. We've got new personal products. We've got cars in there with hi-fi systems in them, whole areas where you can just chill out, play with PlayStation. I mean, you know, you've got to go and see it. It's amazing.
No doubt. But now let's get back to the first thing you mentioned, which I think is making the single biggest amount of headlines here at the show. Companies over the last couple of years have touted, 50 hertz refresh rates and stuff with our LCDs. Amazing. Well, Sony comes out here at IFA and says, oh, yeah? How about 200 hertz?
Yeah, 200.
Now, we know that's more than 50.
Oh,
clever.
Yeah, four times.
Exactly. But what does that mean for us as consumers? How does it make a difference, and why do we care?
Well, good question. Seeing is believing.
Yeah.
I mean, it's very clear when you actually go up to the TV and take a look, because what we've done is we've done quite a clever little split-screen demo. You can stand in front. You can look at a standard conventional speed of image, if you like.
Right, on an LCD we're talking.
That's right,
because it's been
LCD.
An issue with LCDs over the years, but apparently Sony's making some major headway here.
You're absolutely right. The speed of the panel changing, if you like, or what we call the switching or the refresh rate, is very important, because the faster we can make it do, the more film-like the image is. You know, imagine Spider-Man swinging through New York and him juddering a little bit. Well, he doesn't do that.
No, not in real life.
No. Not in real life. He's really quick.
Yes.
So the thing is, if we can speed things up, it means that when fast-moving objects move across the line of vision, they move like reality. Because, you know, let's face it, when you see him, he is quick.
Sure.
It's a very, very convincing demo, though. But seriously, you just have to stand in front of it. We've got various things like cameras panning across objects. We've got rolling text and stuff like that.
And, of course, a lot of sports. This plays an important role if you're watching fast-moving activity.
Absolutely.
Car races and whatnot. Now, why is that not an issue generally with plasma, but it has been a concern with LCD over the years?
Well, I think it's an issue with any display system, because every display system runs at a chosen rate designed by the manufacturer. The faster we can make it operate, if we do it properly, then the better the image quality is going to be for people when they're watching fast-moving objects. No question about it.
Gotcha. Well, of course, now let's talk about, you mentioned Blu-ray as well, and now that Blu-ray has become the world standard, if you will, for high-definition DVD, how are the folks here in Europe accepting Blu-ray? Are they now saying, all right, now it's been decided, we're going to go out and buy Blu-ray?
Absolutely. The reaction in terms of the customer interest is phenomenal. But it's not only that, it's other manufacturers, people that have been waiting to see how things develop, how the market went. People that work in what we call the Java side, which is the kind of technology or the software that allows the disc to do stuff, you know, be interactive, have lots of sort of creative menus and things. Components, suppliers, things like this. The studios, not just the big guys that are turning out the blockbusters that everybody wants to get in HD, but the smaller companies that are releasing, you know, specialist, more niche material. And, of course, the classic reissues. I mean, Disney announced some amazing stuff that's coming out. And when you see it,
and there's another little company called Sony Pictures.
Oh, yeah, better not forget those guys.
Don't forget them.
No. Particularly when they've got some amazing things coming from James Bond later.
Oh, yeah. Sir Howard Stringer was teasing us during the press conference earlier this week with some a little clip, very little clip. I think it was like 6 seconds. But it was a little clip about the new James Bond movie and how there's going to be some interesting marketing efforts to also promote the whole high-def opportunity.
So. I mean, I think Howard was bang on the button with that, because as a company we can do an awful lot to get that message over to people, and we have a lot of resources. We, you know, one of the things that Sony wants to do is to provide a networked range of products, a family of products that not only talk to each other, but do it simply and do it efficiently for people. Because technology can be easy to use. It can be easy to operate. And one of the things that I like to see is the smile on someone's face when they've picked up a variety of new products and pressed a button and they all work together.
Yeah, go figure.
Go figure, yeah, because you can do it. And exactly. That's one of our things, and that's one of the points that Howard was certainly making, and he's right to do so.
I think a lot of our listeners on a regular basis talk in terms of, you know, we don't really care how something works, just that something does. And yeah, that's totally the key, and I think that's a whole lot about what Sony's working on. It's like, that's true. It's not up to the consumers to worry about it. Let us worry about it. Just pick it up and turn it on. There you go.
Yeah, and also feeling comfortable with kit. You know, you pick up a remote control. You don't want to have to then pick up the TV remote and think, whoa, I've got to take some time working this one out. You can kind of like intuitively feel your way around remote controls today. The kind of products that we've got on display show you that. And the media bar, what we call a cross-media bar that came so, you know, very popular with PlayStation. We're working on making our interfaces, you know, the control systems easy and common sense. That's the name.
Eric, you're a lot of fun to chat with, and I hope we get to do it again, too, because there's so much more to talk about, and we will catch up with you. Meantime, of course, Sony.com, Sony.eu specifically for Eric's group and all the things that are working this side of the world. Thanks for joining us. We look forward to getting you back. Maybe we can snag you and some other Sony folks at CES coming up, among other times.
I hope so, yeah.
We'll do it. Thank you, sir. Back with more from IFA Berlin. I'm Dave Graveline. This is Into Tomorrow on the Advanced Media Network.